York City. Woo! Hello, New York City!
Hi, Sam!
I'm very thrilled to be here tonight, I'm very grateful to be here, and I'm feeling very inspired by the young people and all of the people that donated this evening. And I'm thinking, what the hell did I do with my life? I wanted to begin by reading something from John Denver, which is, music brings people together. It allows us to experience the same emotions. People everywhere are the same in heart and spirit. No matter what language we speak, what color we are, the form of our politics, or the expression of our love and our faith, music proves we are the same. And music really does bring people together, and the perfect example of that is the reason why I'm here this evening, and the reason Mr. Adam Lambert is here this evening is because of music and a simple tweet that brought the two of us together with Nile Rodgers, one of our heroes.
Thank you, Sam!
Somebody that we look up to and has inspired us in our music. And unity through social media is what brought us here tonight. Adam and I have known each other for years now. We're getting old. And we've worked together and collaborated on music on both of his albums. And it's an absolute pleasure to know Adam Lambert and to work with him. But Adam Lambert inspires me and a lot of other people because of his tenacity and his commitment to being himself. And please make some noise. In spite of media backlash and public criticism and pressure from within the industry, Adam sticks to his guns. And he does what pleases himself, and that inspires young people, and it inspires people of every generation. So it's my pleasure this evening to present the Unity Award to Mr. Adam Lambert. UNITY, that's a unity.
Well, thank you. Drink more. I wanted to thank Sam, first of all. Sam's amazing. Sam has inspired me musically, personally. We were in a studio writing a song called Shady.
Woo!
Yeah. And we had written the majority of the song, like the lyrics and the melody, and we were looking at the production of it with Lester Mendez, very talented producer. And we said, we need Nile Rodgers style, like disco guitar. And Sam says, tweet him. And so that's what we did. We tweeted Nile, and that's how it worked. No record company, no A&R, none of that business, just us. Yeah. Yeah. And thankfully, it all worked out. I was here in New York a couple weeks later, and we recorded the guitars in the studio one afternoon, and I met Nile for the first time. And he is the nicest guy, just warm and down to earth with amazing stories. And then when he picks up the frickin' guitar, are you kidding? I was so inspired, and the song turned out great, and thanks to that collaboration, I kept up with Nile, and I was asked to be here tonight, and I wanted to thank everybody for coming. I'm fully inspired by the teenagers that got to speak earlier. It makes me feel really insecure about when I was a teenager, because I didn't do anything that cool. I was like busy, you know, trying to make friends. But I guess that's what this is kind of about. It's about making friends. It's about a community. And, you know, with the music business and the entertainment community being a little bit competitive and a little cutthroat at times, it's nice to come here to be reminded that there is a community, that there is family, in all these industries, because we've created ourselves. So thanks everybody for being here tonight, and it's time for some rock and roll and some funk and some dance, and let's